you're here again to learn. Are you ready to learn? Very good. Now, I have here some sentences and I want you to read with me. Are you ready? Very good. Number one, did you meet your teacher? Number one sentence is, did you meet your teacher? Number two sentence is, yes, I do. She is Miss Lani Blanco. Number two sentence is, yes, I do. She is Miss Lani Blanco. Number three sentence is she a good teacher? Number three sentence is she a good teacher? Number four sentence is, yes, she is. She taught us some short verses. Number four sentence is, yes, she is. She taught us some short verses. Number five sentence is, mother cooks food for us every day. Number five sentence is, mother cooks food for us every day. What can you say about these sentences? Very good. Some sentences are answerable with yes or no, and it is in a rising intonation. Very good. How about the other sentences? Some sentences are in a statement, and it is in a falling state intonation. Very good. Now, today we're going to study about rising intonation and falling intonation. Rising intonation are question sentences that are answerable with yes or no, and it ends with a question mark. For example, do birds fly? Number two example is, can you watch the program? Okay, while falling intonation is, it is a kind of a statement and it ends with a period. For example, dogs can bark. Rita can write a letter. Number three, Rosa is a good student. Okay, class, I have here an exercises and I want you to tell me if the sentence is a rising intonation or a falling intonation. Are you ready? Very good. Number one sentence is, are you busy? What kind of intonation is this? Very good. This is a rising intonation. Why? Because it is answerable with yes or no. What else? It ends with a question mark. Very good. Number two sentence is, the boys are busy. The boys are busy. What kind of intonation is this? Very good. This is a falling intonation. Why? Because this is a statement and it ends with a period. Number three sentence. Miss Santos is kind. Miss Santos is kind. What kind of intonation is this? Very good. This is a falling intonation. Why? Because this is a statement. What else? Because it ends with a period. Very good. Number four. Is Miss Santos kind? Number four. Is Miss Santos kind? What kind of intonation is this? Very good. This is a rising intonation. Why? Because it ends with a question mark. What else? Because it is answerable with yes or no. Very good. Now, let's now move to number five sentence. Can Carabao scallop? Number five sentence is, can Carabao scallop? What kind of intonation is this? Very good. This is a rising intonation. Why? Because it ends with a question mark. What else? Because this is a question sentence. Very good. What else? Because it is answerable with yes or no. Very good. Let's now move to number six. Carabaos can gallop. Carabaos can gallop. What kind of intonation is this? Yes, very good. This is a falling intonation. Why? Because it is a statement and it ends with a period. Now, I have here some exercises and I want you to tell me if it is a rising intonation, or a falling intonation. Are you ready? Very good. Number one sentence is, do cats chat? Number one sentence is, do cats chat? What kind of intonation is this? Very good. It is a rising intonation. Why? It is answerable with yes or no. And very good. What else? It is a question sentence. What else? Very good. What else? It is, it ends with a question mark. Very good. Let's now move to number two sentence. No, they don't chat. Number two sentence is, no, they don't chat. What kind of intonation is this? Very good. This is a falling intonation. Why? It is a statement. Very good. What else? It ends with a period. Very good. Let's now move to number three sentence. Can cows fly? Number three sentence is, can cows fly? What kind of intonation is this? Very good. This is a rising intonation. Why? It ends with a question mark. What else? It is answerable with yes or no. Very good. What else? It is a question sentence. Very good. Let's now move to number four sentence. The cows can't fly. Number four sentence is, the cows can't fly. What kind of intonation is this? This is a falling intonation. Why? It is a statement. Very good. What else? It ends with a period. Very good. Number five sentence is, I will invite you to my birthday party next Sunday. Number five sentence is, I will invite you to my birthday party next Sunday. What kind of intonation is this? Very good. It is a falling intonation. Why? Very good. It is a statement. What else? It ends with a period. Very good. Class, I want you to write your answer if it is a rising intonation or a falling intonation. Okay? You listen well, and then you're going to tell me or write this, write your answer on the board, and then, okay, let us check then after, okay? Number one, I am invited. Number one, I am invited. Number two, may I visit your exhibit? Number two, may I visit your exhibit? Number three, trees are useful. Number three, trees are useful. Number four, mother buys a kilo of rice. Number four, mother buys a kilo of rice. Number five, does she paint? Number five, does she paint? Okay, are you done? Let us now check your answers. Who would like to answer? Who would like to write your answer on the board? Very good. Yes, very good. Your answer is a falling intonation. I am invited. It ends with a period and it is a statement. Let's now move to number two sentence. May I visit your exhibit? May I visit your exhibit? What kind of intonation is that? Your answer is a rising intonation. Very good. Because it ends with a question mark and it is answerable with yes or no. Very good. Let's now move to number three. Trees are useful. Trees are useful. What kind of intonation is this? Very good. Your answer is a falling intonation because it is a, very good, it is a statement. What else? It ends with a period. Very good. Let's now move to the number four sentence. Mother buys a kilo of rice. What kind of intonation is this? Your answer is a falling intonation. Very good. Because this is a statement. Very good. And it ends with a period. Very good. Number five sentence is, does she paint? Number five sentence is, does she paint? What kind of intonation is this? Very good. Your answer is a rising intonation. Very good. Because it is answerable with yes or no. What else? It is a question sentence and it ends with a question mark. Very good. Now, I want you to get your paper and pen and then write R if it is a rising intonation and F if it is a falling intonation. Are you ready? Very good. You're going to write your answer in a piece of paper. Number one sentence is, do you like to eat mangoes? Number one sentence is, do you like to eat mangoes? Number two sentence is, milkfish is our national fish. Number two sentence is, milkfish is our national fish. Number three sentence is, Mila is studying her lesson. Number three sentence is, Mila is studying her lesson. Number four sentence is, can dogs bark? Number four sentence is, can dogs bark? Number five sentence is the party a successful one? Number five sentence is the party a successful one? Okay, are you done? Very good. Let us now check your answers. Number one answer is, very good. It is a rising intonation. Why? It is answerable with yes or no. Do you like to eat mangoes? And it ends with a question mark. Number two, what is your answer? Yes, very good. It is a falling intonation. Why? It is a statement. Milkfish is our national fish. And it ends with a period. Very good. Let's now move to number three sentence. Mila is studying her lesson. Your answer is a falling intonation. Very good. Because this is a statement and very good. It is and it ends with a period. Okay? Very good. Let's now move to number four sentence. Can dogs bark? Your answer is a rising intonation. Very good. Because it is answerable with yes or no. Very good. What else? It ends with a question mark. Very good. Let's now move to number five sentence. Is the party a successful one? What is your answer? Very good. It is a rising intonation. Why? It is answerable with yes or no. What else? It ends with a question mark. Very good. Now, for your assignment, I want you to take down, write 5 examples of a rising intonation and a falling intonation. Okay, very good. Well done. Now, okay, bye for now, but we're going to meet tomorrow. Okay? Stay safe. God bless. Have a nice day. This is your teacher, Evelina, saying, we will meet tomorrow. I love you all. Bye for now.